3 or 4 hours later, in the evening, we sustained a barrage of mortar attack coming from the south across the forward defensive line into the no-fire zone and into the food distribution centre. I was kind of crouched between some of the 44-gallon drums and sandbags, and the body of a young woman landed on top of me as some of the shells came in. The explosive force had thrown her and landed kind of on me. She'd been decapitated, and most of her torso and her legs had been torn apart by obviously a fair amount of shrapnel that had gone through her when the shell struck. And I kind of had a sense that I was just waiting to die, my luck was going to run out soon. The scene was devastating. With my limited knowledge of humanitarian law, I realised that in fact what I was witnessing was very, very serious potential war crimes that were being conducted. There's a crucial point to be made about why the Sri Lankan government declared the no-fire zone within the effective range of all of the weaponry being used by the Sri Lankan military to fire in that direction. There is only one intent. You don't really care whether or not you're going to kill the people that are located in that safe zone. Or, more importantly, you're actively targeting them.
Do you believe that's what was happening?
Yes. Yes.
So this is an execution scene with five men dead and a young boy.
The boy is Balachandran Prabhakaran, the 12-year-old son of the Tamil Tiger leader Velupillai Prabhakaran. The murdered men are believed to be his bodyguards.
So he has five gunshot wounds. This was likely the first shot fired, and there's a speckling from propellant tattooing indicating that the distance of the muzzle of the weapon to this boy's chest was 2 to 3 feet or less. So he could have reached out with his hand and touched the gun that killed him. So this is a murder, there's no doubt about it.
Since that interview, we've obtained these chilling photographs. They show Balachandran alive and apparently guarded by a government soldier. Encoded metadata suggests these photographs were taken 2 hours earlier than the ones which show him dead. It seems this young child was held prisoner by government troops and even offered a snack before he was taken and executed in cold blood.
This is a war crime. So what one would expect, of course, is that it would be thoroughly investigated.
Slowly, slowly, everybody was just walking towards the bridge. And this old lady was asking the Sri Lankan officer there for water, and then he just laughed at her and pointed to the dirty water that's going underneath the bridge and said, go and drink that. All I can see is just dead bodies just in with the water, just sort of floating on top of the water. And we just have to, with the hand, just put everything aside and just drink the water.
Girls suspected of being Tamil Tigers are loaded onto trailers to be taken away. These 20 seconds of footage are all we have. We have no idea what happened to them.
When I went for the first time in Bani, left. It's just beautiful land. And now I'm just looking around, and this is just like dead bodies everywhere, burnings, shell bombs. And it just looked very dead and dark everywhere.